Humans have 20 different amino acids, which mainly serve as the building blocks for proteins. But some amino acids, with a little modification, go on to become neurotransmitters, compounds which are the main mode of communication between brain cells, or even hormones, which exert their effects throughout the body. The amino acid, which becomes the media darling every Thanksgiving, is tryptophan. The story goes like this. Turkey contains tryptophan, which in the brain is converted to serotonin, a neurotransmitter implicated in mood disorders, and in fruit flies has been shown to cause somnolence. Serotonin is then converted in the pineal gland to melatonin, a hormone which helps regulate the sleep-wake cycle in humans, and whose supplementation might help with falling asleep. So, turkey makes us sleepy, right? Well, if there's one thing to take away from this video, it's that the human body is rarely that simple. All those biochemical cycles, endocrine pathways, feedback loops, cellular physiology, it's just too much. Okay, back on track. After tryptophan is absorbed from the gut into the blood, it still needs to get into the brain to have any possibility of causing sleepiness. Most of the brain is protected by parts of blood vessels and supporting cells, which form what's called the blood-brain barrier. This keeps unwanted substances from entering the brain and requires most compounds to go through specific transporters to get in. Think about it like that shaped sorter toy that babies play with. Not everything can get into the box, and each shape has its own specific hole. While some compounds analogously have their own personal transporters to get through, tryptophan shares its transporter with a group of amino acids, collectively called large neutral amino acids. To get more tryptophan into the brain, you need a higher ratio of tryptophan in the blood as compared to these other amino acids. Here's the problem with this terrible turkey tryptophan tall tale that's touted tenaciously through timeless Thanksgivings. First off, turkey is nothing special. No offense. It has about the same amount of tryptophan per unit weight as chicken. Even then, tryptophan is the least abundant amino acid in most animal proteins. So eating turkey increases blood tryptophan levels, but decreases the ratio of tryptophan to large neutral amino acids, meaning it gets outcompeted when trying to enter the brain and can't go on to form these sleep-inducing compounds. Turns out, a compound found in milk whey, alpha-lactalbumin, has the highest tryptophan to large neutral amino acid ratio of all food proteins and can increase that ratio in the blood by 130%. Interestingly, eating carbohydrates, which by definition don't have tryptophan, also increases tryptophan concentration in the brain. Carbs lead to increased blood glucose, which causes insulin secretion. Insulin then stimulates muscles to take up large neutral amino acids, but not tryptophan, increasing the blood tryptophan to large neutral amino acid ratio by about 20%. That increased ratio then leads to increased tryptophan passage through the blood-brain barrier. There is evidence that suggests tryptophan supplementation without those pesky large neutral amino acids could make people feel sleepy, but you won't get that with your Thanksgiving turkey. Instead, that post-meal sleepiness is more likely from other causes. We discussed earlier a mechanism where carbs could lead to increased brain tryptophan. And increased blood glucose alone is thought to decrease the activity of excitatory pathways in the brain. Additionally, loading and stretching of your stomach and small intestine have been shown to induce sleepiness, with your body switching from a fight or flight state to a rest and digest state. So does that timeless tender turkey's terrific tryptophan temper troublesome tensions toward tranquility? Nope, it doesn't. But combine it with those mashed potatoes and four slices of pie, and that will probably do the trick.